All right, guys, today I'm going to be doing an unboxing of a new pistol. It's not only a new pistol for me, it's a new type of pistol I don't have a lot of experience shooting. This is the ammo I'm going to be using, Winchester and Remington. Pretty cheap, basically Walmart stuff you can find pretty much anywhere. I figure if you can run through this stuff, I should be okay. I don't run steel case ammo through my pistols, but I only use steel case ammo through my AK, so it's a little interesting dynamic there. I'm going to try out a different type of target for me today. It's supposed to be a target where you hit it and it's reactive, and hopefully it stays together. I had a target similar to this, but one of the problems with these type of targets is that if you don't aim right, if you aim too low, you're going to hit this metal piece right here. And once that happens, you got to find a replacement. So that's one of the weaknesses. But anyway, here's a new pistol. And I've been looking at a number of 45s for a while. And this is the first one I decided to go with. Of course, it comes in a Glock bag. But interesting enough, it's not actually a Glock. strangely enough, when she put it in the Glock bag, I thought, oh boy, did I just make a big mistake or something? But anyway, you guys know I'm a big Glock fan. It's the only guns I've really been shooting and owning. I had owned a Springfield one time, but I sold that. I had a weird problem with that. At one point, with that little Springfield 9mm, I noticed that when I filled up the regular magazine, I couldn't release it. But when I would just get rid of one round, I was able to actually release the magazine. But anyway, back to this. SIG. Never been a SIG person. Don't know anything about SIG. I am a pretty big fan of striker fire pistols. The Glock 21 was my first pistol, and it remains my favorite pistol. When you get this pistol, it comes with an actual manual, as all of them do. Comes with a little cleaning tool. I decided to buy this in addition to this. Get some lubricant. Comes with two magazines. And here is the pistol itself. It looks like a 226, but it's actually a 227 and 45. 227. And yeah, this is my first non-striker fire pistol. I did go to a range and shoot a couple HKs, HK USP and HK 45, and I loved them both. One thing I don't like about the HK USP is that the magazine release was just too small. When the HK 45, I was able to reach the magazine release. Now this gun really surprised me. It's not a polymer gun in the sense that it doesn't have a grip that's polymer. It doesn't have a polymer frame like the Glock 21 that I'm used to carrying. Yeah, the Glock does feel a little bit lighter. Definitely feels a little bit lighter right there. But this frame is not as heavy. It's alloy, and it's not actually as heavy as I thought it would be, an all metal gun. And it's definitely comparable in the size to my Glock 21. There are some differences. I'll get into that in another video, but really, this is a hammer fired pistol. And it's pretty fascinating because, you know, the striker fire pistols tend to be cheaper. This is definitely a lot more expensive. And I'm going to do a video shooting this for my very first time. Just want to give you a good look at it. I had the option to get sort of like a chrome type of slide. It was, I forgot the name of it, but I really don't go for the looks that much, but it does look like a really nice gun. It looks like a nice gun, and I did read that there were some problems with the 227, in that there was something wrong with the roll pin, but that was back in 2013, and hopefully they fixed that issue right there. Whenever there's a new gun, there's always going to be some issues initially. Even Glock had issues with the Glock Generation 4. And I'll just hope that they worked it out. And if they didn't work it out, then I'll have to send it back to SIG. One thing that was really encouraging is that I was able to call the customer service before I bought the pistol. I called the customer service to see who would answer it, whether I would have an American on the phone or whether I would have somebody from India or something. You know, that sort of mattered to me. Some nice American lady answered the phone. Well, she sounded like an American, and she was actually a pretty nice person. So release the magazine. definitely a strong spring. I think this is how you break down pistol. Okay, there you go. Nice long slide. Just a lot of areas to put contact. I hear that this gun is better if you actually lube it, and that's something that I usually don't do with the Glock. There's a barrel, slide inside. Anyway, guys, I'll let you know how things work out. Thanks for watching, thanks for listening, and don't forget the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.
Start off with double action.